Okay, well, here with Cetro, a few hours before the Exodus show in Buenos Aires. So the first question would be from your past, your really long past with Testament, with Legacy. We will see what can you remember about this. You were the vocalist of Legacy, the first incarnation.
Sure.
Of Testament,
right.
You recorded their demo with them.
Exactly.
What do you remember of those 3 years you spent with the band and the memories with Alex and Eric and the other guys? Le estoy preguntando a Cetro qué recuerda de sus 3 años que pasó con Legacy, que fue la primera encarnación de Testament y con la que grabó su primer demo allá a comienzos de los 80.
The beginning of anything that ends up like this is always kind of cool. So when it turns out that it's almost 30 years later, in fact it is 30 years later, to look back on it and to look at everyone's career, you know, Alex, besides the fact that he's Testament's guitar player, is considered one of the best guitar players in the world. Well, I remember the day that I went to his house to ask him if he could join the band. He was 15. So to think of those memories and all the history we have now, it's monumental. It's really great for us and great for me as well.
Mm-hmm.
I get such an excitement out of, you know, being in Exodus, but as well as I had so much to do with Legacy. I call it Legacy. It was Legacy when I was there, mm-hmm. but obviously everybody knows them as Testament, and they're one of the biggest heavy metal bands in the world.
How many shows did you play with them? Or no, there were no shows at the time.
3 years worth.
Yeah,
so
of course, like Legacy, yeah.
3 years worth, so 50?
50 shows.
Sure, 60 maybe, I don't know. We played almost every weekend somewhere, mm-hmm. so maybe even more.
Mm-hmm. You composed some of the songs of the demo. Almost all of the songs.
In fact, all the lyrics I wrote.
All right, that later become part of the first Testament.
Correct. Album. I wrote everything on that album, except for Apocalyptic City and Do or Die, but all the rest of the lyrics were mine.
Okay.
And I still write for them. The last two records
right.
I have written, I wrote on Formation. I wrote More Than Meets the Eye and Dangers of the Faithless. And then on Dark Roots of Earth, I wrote, Chuck and I wrote together, we wrote True American Hate. And then Alex and I wrote together A Day in the Death. And then I wrote Throne of Thorns by myself.
Okay.
So I still help out. Of course, Chuck and I did Dublin Death Patrol too. So
mm-hmm.
him and I are very much intertwined. And ironically, he manages Exodus now too.
Yeah.
So it's a very incestual business, the Bay Area thrash scene.
Yeah.
But it's really worked out great for all of us.
Nos decía Cetro que recuerda, tiene muy buenos recuerdos de los primeros 3 años de su carrera con Legacy, porque bueno, ahí se originó todo, toda la movida de la Bay Area del trash, y bueno, fueron más de 50 shows que dio con Legacy. Recuerda la primera vez que fue Alex Skolnick a su casa, él tenía 15 años cuando se conocieron, y tiene muy buenos recuerdos de esa época. Él compuso casi todas las canciones, las letras del primer demo de Legacy, que luego se transformaron en parte de los discos de los primeros discos de Testament. Y dice, aclara, que sigue colaborando con Testament en los nuevos discos, componiendo canciones. Which were the songs you mentioned that you songwrote for Testament in the last years?
Last 2 years on The Formation of Damnation, I wrote More Than Meets the Eye and Dangers of the Faithless. And then on Dark Roots of Earth, it was True American Hate, Day in the Death, and Throne of Thorns.
Ok, esas fueron las canciones con las que Cetro colaboró en los últimos años de Testament. Ok, now, so second question is, how did you left the band when Chuck entered the band, I mean Legacy Testament, how did you left the band? And it's because you were offered the spot in Exodus in 1995. Le estoy preguntando cómo fue que dejó la banda Legacy, si fue porque entró Chuck o porque le ofrecieron el puesto en Exodus en 1985.
I was already in Exodus. I had already auditioned kind of silently, so I had already had the job. But I had one more show I had to play, and I didn't want anybody to find out.
What's the secret?
The secret got out.
Yeah.
So before I played the show, it was before the Legacy show, everyone knew. It was a very sad moment for all of us. We all actually cried tears, but they knew it was such a great, it was a good move for me. And then when I saw Chuck about a couple of days later, I think I was out like jogging or something, and I saw Chuck, and I told him to try out. And he's all, thrash metal's that? And oh man, these guys got like 12 record deals on the table waiting for them. I go, you'll do really well. So I actually went to the first
He supported you.
Of course, I was the one who told him to try out. So I went to practice with him for 2 weeks to show him how to sing the songs.
All right.
Yeah, so it was all very amicable. It was really cool.
Okay, dice Cetro que bueno, cuando él se dejó Legacy, ya se había probado secretamente con Exodus, sin que nadie supiera, y ya le habían ofrecido el puesto. Y cuando Alex Skolnick se enteró, le dijo, bien hecho, man, o sea, dale para adelante, que Exodus ya tiene un contrato como por 8 discos, 10 discos, así que tuvo el total apoyo de la banda. Ok, for Pleasures of the Flesh, your first album with Exodus, did you have the chance to write all the lyrics? Because a demo was already recorded with Paul. Le estoy preguntando si para el primer disco de Exodus que grabó Pleasures of the Flesh compuso las letras, porque ya existía un demo grabado con Paul Baloff.
Actually, there were some songs written, but I did have a big hand in writing the lyrics on that one. I wrote Till Death Do Us Part. I wrote Faster Than You Ever Lived to Be. I wrote Chemikill. I wrote the second part to Seeds of Hate, and Gary and I both wrote Choose Your Weapon.
You mean the lyrics?
The lyrics, yes, the lyrics.
Because
but
the
Gary
demo
wrote everything else.
All right.
The demo had Brain Dead, Seeds of Hate, and Pleasures of the Flesh on it. But there was a part in Seeds of Hate at the end that I sang, kind of rapid fire singing, that wasn't in it, and I wrote that part. So.
Ah, okay, okay. Dice Cetro que bueno, las canciones de Pleasures of the Flesh escribió la mayoría de las letras, porque las letras que había en el demo anterior con Paul no eran las mismas. Él ahí nombró recién las letras que ya estaban compuestas y las que, bueno, las que compuso para Pleasures of the Flesh. Okay, next question is, which were the, exactly the causes that you left Exodus twice, and how and why you returned to the fold now? How were you offered to get back into Exodus?
First,
all the hatches are buried deep down now that you are back together. Le pregunto a Cetro que bueno, él dejó la banda anteriormente dos veces. Le pregunto cuáles fueron las razones por las que se fue y cómo se dio la vuelta ahora. Y le pregunto bueno, si todas las posibles enemistades con el resto ya no existen.
The initial time I did not quit, Gary ended the band in 93. He put the band to a stop. I did not quit. The last show was in Japan. In fact, I was approached by a ton of press that were just in a room with him when he said, when we go home, the band's over with. And so they came up to me, Zetro, Zetro, Gary says that the band, this is the band's last show. That's how that happened in 93. 10 years ago, there was other things going on with me, you know? Problems with family,
all right.
Problem with drugs, other things that made it not possible for me to be here with my head in the game, basically.
Okay.
So I play in Hatred, you know that. And
yeah.
Both of my sons play in Hatred.
Mm-hmm.
Well, my sons are now 24 and 20.
We are going to talk about Hatred.
Well, this has a part to do with it. There's the boys are now 24 and 20. Back then they were 14 and 10.
Yeah.
So Cody, the oldest one, started getting brought home by the police. And I didn't want to have, I decided to have those children. And I didn't want to be the father that Ozzy was to his first children. I didn't want to be that. And at the time, Exodus wasn't making the money that I was making on a job that I had at home. I'm a union carpenter, foreman. I make good money in California, you know,
okay.
When I have to work.
You were a carpenter.
Yeah, I just recently left. I was in for 21 years.
All right.
I'm vested, fully annuity, full pension, everything. So now I can go do this. So mentally, at that time, and to make it explain it simply, the band was number three.
Yeah.
Family was number one. Job was number two. Now, band is number one. Band is number two. Band is number three. Band is
all
number
right.
four. So you won't find me leaving this band again. I'm very excited and very happy to be back.
You were offered to be back, or?
Oh, definitely offered. I was asked to audition. Yes.
All right. All right. Bueno, Cetro nos contaba que la primera vez que se fue de la banda en 1993 was the first time.
1993. Correct.
All right. Se fue. En realidad no se fue de la banda, sino que después de una última fecha que dieron en Japón. Gary decidió separar la banda, a él se lo comunicaron en el camarín, decidieron separar la banda y no es que se fue. Y cuando él volvió para grabar Temple of the Damned, cuando él, perdón, él se fue nuevamente de la banda, decidió irse de la banda después de grabar Temple of the Dam, fue por motivos familiares y, bueno, problemas de drogas que él tenía, y aparte le pasaba que los dos hijos que él tenía tenían 15 años y también tenían problemas, volvían a la casa, los traía la policía, bueno, tenían muchos problemas. Por eso decidió alejarse de la banda. Aparte tenía su profesión de carpintero, que era muy redituable, entonces trabajó de eso, y ahora que sus hijos son grandes y tocan con él en Hate Riots, bueno, cree que es el momento oportuno, le ofrecieron volver a Exodus y bueno, acá está de vuelta. Ok, next question. For me the last great Exodus album is Temple of the Damned.
Thank you.
How can you describe the new one? Because I haven't had the chance to hear it yet, to listen to it yet. So, do you have compositions of your own, and or all the album was already some written before you entered the band? Le estoy preguntando, gracias, thank you, Cetro. Le estoy preguntando, justamente, que le estoy diciendo que mi último disco favorito de Exodus es Temple of the Damned, el último que grabó él, y le pregunto cómo describiría el nuevo disco, Blood In, Blood Out, que acaban de grabar, si grabó o compuso algo para ese disco, o entró cuando ya estaba compuesto.
I did write one song on the album, which was actually lyrically written by Rob initially. We didn't change the title, we just changed the lyrics, and it was actually myself, Jack, and Lee. We were in the studio while I was doing my vocals for all the other song, and within 45 minutes, we wrote Body Harvest. And so that was the song.
Body Harvest.
Body Harvest, that was the song. And thank you for your kind words about Temple of the Damned. That is a great record.
Of course, I love it.
And if you love Temple of the Damned, you're really going to love Blood In, Blood
Out. Right.
Because I just have two words to say. Part two.
All right.
It's that good, and you're really good. And you'll think so. And I think the band, the sound you'll feel is a little bit more of the retro, like with back with me. But it was all written with Rob in mind, so I don't think that it was done purposely. I think that it just works out. You heard the two songs, obviously.
Yeah, yeah.
Blood In, Blood Out, Salt and Wounds. So I think that the album's really more in the vein of Blood In, Blood Out. It's very fast, very heavy, very angry album. And I think that
you fit perfectly with the things that were already.
Definitely, yes, yes, for sure. I because I had been in the band with so much history, you know, I've known these guys since I was 21 years old, you know, so I know how they are. I know how to do Exodus.
I did
Exodus before, so it was just about coming in and being me and being Zetro with Exodus, and that it was pretty much. Mm-hmm. I mean, again, because I've done Hatriot and I write music for Testament, and I did the Tenet and DDP. This is really in fine tune right now, so I was ready for it.
All right. Bueno, Cetro cuenta un poquito que entró para Blood In, Blood Out, que ya estaba compuesto para Rob Dukes. Pero que encajó perfectamente su voz con lo que ya estaba hecho, pero que sí tuvieron la chance de componer una canción, la letra de una canción para Blood In or Blood Out, which is the song you write for
Body Harvest.
Body Harvest es la canción que él pudo escribir para Blood In, Blood Out, y que se siente perfecto con el disco, y que lo ve como una auténtica continuación de Temple of the Damned, el último disco en el que estuvo. Ok, so which song of Blood In, Blood Out do you want to hear right now?
This song is called Numb.
Okay, let's go with Numb. We'll be right back. Going back with Blood In, Blood Out, with Andy Snip producing the album, which I think is a genius, and Chuck Billy and Kirk Hammett as guests, it looks like a perfect dream team, reunion thrash metal album. I guess you have high hopes for this one. So do you have a plan to have a more permanent stay in the band, a long term? Le estoy preguntando, thank you Cetro again, le estoy preguntando que bueno, es como un supergrupo de thrash metal, Blood In, Blood Out, porque está Andy Snip produciendo, que es un genio en la producción, y también están invitados Chuck Billy, Kirk Hammett, bueno, le pregunto si esto se siente realmente como casi un supergrupo, y si tiene muchas esperanzas por este disco, expectativas, y si planea permanecer en la banda mucho tiempo más.
I'm not going anywhere. I'm here for the duration, I'm here for the long haul, I'm here forever. You can guarantee, unless I'm dead, that I can, nobody else will be holding the microphone for Exodus. I will All be right. here for the rest of the time. Again, sometimes you're very lucky to get an opportunity to come back to you, and maybe you let it go and should not have let it go. And at the time when I let it go, my life was a mess. My life is todo limpio right now, so I'm great, I'm very excited, I love going on stage, I'm very excited to meet all the fans and even the younger ones that didn't get to see me or get to hear me, and so it's all new, having guys, you know, well, Chuck's on our management, Kirk and Gary, especially the last few years that they've been doing the Big Fours, because Gary plays in Slayer, that they've really retouched again, and so these two, you get them on stage and they're like two little kids, it's unbelievable. We did actually in July, we played Kirk Hammett's Fear Fest at Comic-Con in San Diego. And I mean, you know, Kirk doesn't have to do that. He's out there laughing, having a great time. So it was, it's great to have that. I believe that this record's really set up really well to do great things for us.
Cetro dice que tiene muchísimas expectativas por este nuevo disco y que pueden estar todos seguros que se va a quedar al pie del micrófono de Exodus por mucho tiempo. Dice que no planea que nadie más agarre el micrófono de Exodus y que bueno, se siente ahora limpio de drogas y de todo como para hacer un gran trabajo. Y que bueno, nada, se siente re bien con que Kirk Hammett haya participado. Por ejemplo, Kirk, además de Metallica, tiene su propio festival en Estados Unidos, que no tenía por qué haber hecho esta colaboración y sin embargo lo hizo solamente porque son amigos, y que bueno, tiene todas las expectativas y todas las pilas con este nuevo disco de Exodus. Okay, you visited Argentina the last time a long time ago, like 20 years ago, yes, with Motorhead.
Yes.
I was there. That was one of my first international big concerts. Do you remember something of the show? Because I can't remember anything, because I was really young. Le estoy preguntando, su última visita con Exodus fue hace ya 20 años con Motorhead, y le pregunto si, bueno, recuerda algo de ese show, porque fue mi primer, uno de mis primeros shows internacionales y yo no me acuerdo de nada.
I remember everything about that show.
Cool.
The thing that I remember the best is that, and we brought that even here to South America with this time, is that the Argentinian crowd, the Buenos Aires crowd, is just crazy. And they, and everybody, I mean, for probably the last 20 years, have always asked me, oh, you've been all around the world, where's the best place to play? And I've always said, Buenos Aires, Argentina.
Really?
For one, I think the women are very beautiful.
La mujer
es muy bonita. And also, I feel that the crowd is just really, really excited. Now, not to say that the rest of South America is not, because Brazil is great, Paraguay was great, but when we all saw Buenos Aires on the itinerary, I think every one of us put a circle around it.
Okay. Dice Cetro que se acuerda básicamente hace 20 años con Motorhead, de lo bien que la pasaron, de que recuerda el público, recuerda por supuesto lo que dicen todos los músicos, las chicas de acá de Argentina, y que siempre están
las chicas
y que siempre están esperando volver a Sudamérica y Argentina para tocar. Okay, last two questions.
Sure.
That's okay?
No problem.
You started your own band in 2010, Hatriot,
Hatriot,
and recorded two albums.
Exactly.
I see that you like to speak about your band. How is playing there with you, both of your sons? Le estoy preguntando a Cetro, que bueno, él empezó su propia banda en el 2010, ya hace 4 años, que se llama Hatriot, y grabaron 2 discos y toca con sus 2 hijos. Le pregunto qué se siente tocar con sus 2 hijos.
very lucky, very fortunate, very excited. How great is that to be able to play music, this type of music, and then have both of your sons come and play with you, and not just play as like, you know, like in a garage band or at a bar. We're actually a real band with records out and stuff, so it's really exciting, and we are trying to bring Hatriot here early next year.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not stopping that. When Gary goes to play with Slayer, excuse me, and Lead goes and plays to Heathen, we're going to do Hatriot. So we're actually writing the third record right now. So I hope to record the new album in 2015. So 3 years, three albums.
All right. I was listening to both of your albums last night before.
Have you ever heard them before?
Yes, I heard the first one when it came out, but just to refresh my memory, I was listening to them.
Second one's fucking strong.
Yeah. The second one's great. Yeah. It's called Dawn of the New Centurion. All right. Nos decía Cetro que se siente excelente estar en tu banda con tus dos hijos. Aparte, your sons are like 20-something now.
Cody, my bass player, is 24. And Nick, the drummer, he's 21.
Okay. Sus hijos tienen 24 y 21, que se siente excelente, parecen una banda de garage, tocando con nueva sangre, nuevos pibes, y que sus planes son grabar el tercer disco ahora, y que cuando Gary vuelva a tocar con Slayer y Lee toque con Heathen, estoy hablando de los miembros de Exodus, por supuesto, él quiere volver a Hate Riot en ese impasse de Exodus y hacer una gira sudamericana también. Okay, the name of the band, Hate Riot, is a mix of hate and riot or hate and patriot?
Probably hate and patriot.
Okay, so you have like a theme of American patriotism. Would you define yourself as the...
This is what a hatriot is. A hatriot is somebody, and you could be a hatriot if you like. A hatriot is somebody who loves their country and is for the people, but doesn't necessarily agree with the government or the police or the things that people do with power. So a hatriot, yeah, I love being American. Do I agree with everything the Americans or the president does? Certainly not.
But you don't define yourself as the Ted Nugent of thrash metal?
What's that?
Do you define yourself as the Ted Nugent of thrash metal?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah? You support him?
Yeah, of course. I love. In fact, on the first song, on the first song of Dawn of the New Centurion, there's a line that says, "So give old Uncle Ted a shout and join the NRA." Uncle Ted is Uncle Ted Nugent.
I know, yeah.
And join the NRA. Adrenalize your hunting size from small to the extreme.
All right.
So I'm definitely important that he's a true American.
Okay. Le preguntaba si el nombre Hatriot es una mezcla de las palabras hate, odio, y riot, que es revuelta, o hate y patriot, que es patriotismo. Y él me dice que definitivamente es una mezcla de hate, odio y patriotismo, porque él cree, se siente orgulloso de ser americano, pero sin necesidad de estar a favor del gobierno, por supuesto, sino de sentirse que apoya a su nación y que se define, le preguntaba de una manera graciosa si se define como el Ted Nugent del thrash metal, y él dice que sí, porque inclusive al comienzo del último disco de Hate Riot hace una mención a Uncle Ted, así que bueno, es patriota el hombre. Okay, this is the last question. It's not a question. Which song do you want to hear from Hate Riot right now?
This song is called Suicide Run.
Yeah. Exodus, and you are watching and listening to Metal Eyewitness. So get in your front room and start a pit right now.